CNN, Washington.
All right, it is a make or break week for President Obama's health care plan this week. Democrats think they will be able to get a bill passed in the next few days. Republican Congressman Brian Bilbray joins us on the phone this morning. Good morning, Congressman.
Good morning, Dave.
Deadline of Thursday. The president said it. Your reaction to the Democrats believing they can get enough votes by then?
Well, first of all, Dave, they don't even know how much it's going to cost. So we still haven't had it rated, but that's typical Washington. Don't worry about the cost. Just shove it through. It's an extraordinary week. You're here seeing arms are being twisted, earmarks promised, and deals are being made. We actually stayed in Friday and voted on algae bloom rather than talking about what we need to do about the economy and getting jobs out there. So I think Thursday's the vote. I think that they are going to pull the stops out there. The word I've gotten is they're promising all kinds of billions of dollars of earmarks to, spread out so that people can be persuaded to change their no to a yes on this.
Yeah, we heard this morning they're spending more than $1 million a day just to twist the arms.
Yeah, it's one of those things. The worst thing that I think we can do right now is show the American people that Washington hasn't been reformed. And that's one big reason why you saw the Republicans on the House last week just said, look, we're going to pull the stops out. No more earmarks. We're not going to ask for it. No Republican in the House is going to get an earmark in this cycle because we've got to just force a true reform and stop these kind of deals. And, you know, this is using taxpayers' money to get people to vote against what their constituency wants, figuring that that'll pay them off in the long run. So this is all really a scary time, but I think Thursday is going to be the vote.
But, Congressman, you talk about the constituency. It's going to be a frustrated one come Thursday, even if it doesn't pass. Where do we go from there? What's next?
Well, what we do is let's talk about reducing cost and impact before we start promising more programs and more sweetheart deals. I mean, we can sit there and say that it's government that stops consumers from being able to buy insurance out of state. The state legislatures have done that, and we need to overrule that. We need to address the tort reform issue. You know, as a county supervisor, I provided the health care system for the poor, and we've got to get the lawyers out of the operating room. This is, you know, we have special protection for the doctors who run the community clinics from tort, because we couldn't run our community clinics without that kind of protection. That kind of protection for all doctors from attorneys ought to be a universal appliance. But right now, the thing is, seems to be that the bigger and the more you promise, the better. And we don't know how we're going to pay for the promises we already have on the board, let alone expanding it. And then to have the cynical situation of saying, we're going to tax you for 10 years and provide benefits for only 6, and oh, this looks so good on paper. You know, what happens when you really got to go 1 year to 1 year? This is a very scary thing. And I just think that a lot of people have just got to understand the credibility of Washington needs to be reestablished before you start making any more promises. You need to keep the promises you kept. You've already made before you start making more.
Congressman, let's talk about Mexico for just a moment. Front page of our paper and probably every paper in the country is the violence, the 3 people killed, 2 U.S. citizens in Juarez over the weekend, and now this new travel advisory. What's your take on this? Have we reached that next step? Is this just continuing to grow?
Well, Dave, you know, when I was sent back here, in 06, one of the messages was, look, the border is out of control, and it's America's fault that we're not addressing it, is that we can shut down that illegal activity if we make enough of a commitment. We send troops all around the world to control other borders, but we won't make the investment because of political correctness to make sure we secure the border. And more people die every year trying to cross the border illegally, and now we have thousands are being killed on the Mexican side. And the fact is, it's all based on illegal activity crossing that border. And if we truly want to protect our neighbors to the south and our own neighborhoods, we need to address this. That's one reason why I worked with George Bush and with this president of saying we need to work on the MITRE initiative to help Mexico win the battle in their streets before it spreads over into ours. And we've already seen it spread into San Diego.
If you had a vacation plan and a vacation spot in Mexico, would you go?
Frankly, Dave, I've taken my family to El Salvador rather than Northern Baja, where we used to spend every Easter we used to go into Mexico. Now I'm going, taking the family more to Central America. That's a pretty sad statement from somebody who was born on the border.
Yeah. Congressman Bilbray, thank you so much. Always a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you, Dave.